Dying Light 2 Stay Human is the sequel to the 2015 Dying Light, and unlike the original, which is powered by Chrome Engine 6, this one uses Techland in-house engine, C-Engine, which offers of course substantial improvement compared to the previous one, and also support for the DX12 Ultimate features such as ray tracing, as well as DLSS and FSR. But in terms of settings and tweaking, this game doesn't offer enough options, and the menu lacks regular settings like shadows, textures, and anisotropic filtering, and more. But despite that, and as always, we'll try to get the best performance and visuals out of what we have. So without any further ado, let's get going. Let's start with DX11 and DX12. If you have a GPU that supports DX12 Ultimate, like an RTX card or 6000 series from AMD, you will get DX12 Ultimate as additional option. Now in terms of performance, DX11 comes out on top and uses less VRAM overall, and offers more stable experience since DX12 caused a lot of stuttering during my testing, as you can see here. The 1% low goes down to 24 FPS and 11 FPS sometimes, which indicate inconsistent performance. Next, let's test one of the DX12 features supported by my GPU, which is Async Compute. This one gives a small FPS uplift, so if you want to use DX12, I recommend keeping this one on. Anti-aliasing comes with two options, low and high. I don't know if you will be able to notice the difference due to YouTube compression, but high offers more stable image and reduced blurring caused by TAA, and the performance is almost similar between the two options. So here I recommend sticking with high, especially if you are playing at a lower resolution. Particles quality also have two options, and overall I had a hard time spotting the difference between low and high, but high hit the performance by 3%, so I'll keep this one on low. Next we have contact shadow. This one adds a screen space shadow to object close to surface, as you can see here, between none, which disables this effect, and very high. It also affects NPCs, like here, you can see a little subtle shadow under this character hand. Performance wise, there is almost no difference between none and very high, so it's simple here, go for very high. One of the most important settings is ambient occlusion. This one significantly impacts the game visuals, like you can see here with these examples. The game without AO looks rough and bad. Performance wise, there is almost no difference from none to low, and 8% cost to high. Fortunately, low doesn't cost much compared to none, and still offers good quality. So if you have enough FPS to spare, I recommend going for high, and if not, then stick with low and don't disable ambient occlusion. Global illumination is another one that I really had a hard time spotting the difference between the two options it offers. But here you can see the high adds some little shadow in here, and performance wise there is almost no difference between low and high. Here just use high. One of the most demanding settings in this game is reflections. This one in most areas controls how much objects of the screen space is included in reflections. As you can see here, where high covers more of this hill in the reflection. Now when it comes to performance, as I said before, reflections are demanding. Here by going from low to medium, we lost 9%, and to high, a massive 23%. Here I recommend sticking with low if you have a low-end GPU and you need every frame you can get, since low doesn't completely disable reflections in most scenes. Another demanding setting is fog quality, which adjusts the resolution and quality of volumetric lighting. Outdoor you won't notice any difference between low and high, even though the FPS dropped by 18%. But indoor and in certain places is where the difference starts to appear, like here where low looks unstable on low res compared to medium and high. Performance wise, there is 9% caused by going from low to medium, and as I said before, 18% to high. Now, since most of the gameplay takes place outdoor and even indoor, you won't see light chests a lot, I recommend sticking with low here. Now to recap, on one hand, most settings in this game don't affect the game visuals or performance like global illumination, particles, etc. But on the other hand, we have three important settings that you should tweak for the best performance and visuals. I'm talking about reflections, fog, and especially ambient occlusion. And with all this, my recommended settings are as follows: anti-aliasing on high, particles on low, contact shadow on very high, ambient occlusion go for low or high, global illumination high, reflections low or medium, and finally fog on low. Now let's do a comparison between high preset, which is the maximum preset in this game, and optimized settings. I'll be using 1440p resolution and DX11. Here at this area you can see 25% increase, and since most settings has no impact visually, the two scenes looks almost identical. And here is another comparison. We arrive at the end. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like. If not, leave a dislike. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more similar videos in the future, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one.